We started with the theme factoring a polynomial. Take your pen, take your copy books, and write down factoring a polynomial. Factoring a polynomial. The function f of x is a 0 times x to the power of n plus a first times x to the power of n minus 1 plus etc. plus a nth, where n is an integer. Is known as a polynomial or a rational integral function of x. Polynomial of a rational integral function of x. The number n is called the degree of the polynomial. Degree of the polynomial. Here, the coefficient a 0, a 1, etc. to a n's are real or complex numbers. A 0, A 1, etc. A n are real or complex numbers. The independent variable x can also take on both real and complex values. Oh, sorry. The root of polynomial is that value of the variable x at which the polynomial becomes zero. The root of a polynomial is that value of the variable x at which the polynomial becomes zero. Consider theorem first. The first theorem, remainder theorem. Theorem. Sorry. First remainder theorem. Division of a polynomial f of x by x minus a yields a remainder equal to f of a. Proof. The quotient obtained by the division of f of a by x minus a, maybe write down this. will be a polynomial f first of x. Of degree 1 less than that of f of x, and the remainder will be a constant R. We can thus write f of x equals x minus a times f first of x plus r, formula 1. This equality holds for all values of x different from a. Division by x minus a when x equals a is meaningless. Maybe write down this. Now let x approach a. Then the limit of the left side of 1 will equal f of a. F of a. While the limit of the right side will equal R. Since the function f of x and x minus a times f first of x plus R are equal for all x don't equal to a, their limits are likewise equal as x approaches a, that is, f of a equals r. Corollary. A is a root of the polynomial, that is if f of a equals 0, then x minus a divided f of x without remainder, and hence f of x is represented in the form of a product. Sage. F of x equals x minus a times f first of x, where f first of x is a polynomial. Consider the example. The polynomial f of x is x cubed minus 6x squared plus 11x minus 6 becomes 0 for x is 1. Thus, f of 1 equals 0. And so x minus 1 divides this polynomial without remainder. X cubed minus 6x squared plus 11x minus 6 is x minus 1 times x squared minus 5x plus 6. Let us now consider equation in one unknown x. Any number, real or complex, which when substituted into the equation in place of x, converts the equation into an identity is called a root of the equation. It's team. Example 2. The numbers 1st is pi over 4, 2nd is 5 pi over 4, 3rd is 9 pi over 4, etc. Are the roots of the equation. Cosine of x equals sine of x. If the equation is of the form p of x equals 0, where p of x is a polynomial of degree n, it is called an algebraic equation of degree n. From the definition, it follows that the root of an algebraic equation p of x equals 0 are the same as are the roots of the polynomial P of X. Quite naturally, the question arises. Does every equation have roots? In the case of non-algebraic equation, the answer is no. There are non-algebraic equations which do not have a single root, either real or complex. For example, the equation e to the power of x equals 0. Maybe we write down it. There are non-algebraic equations which do not have a single root. Either real or complex. For example, the equation e to the power of x equals 0. But in the case of an algebraic equation, the answer is yes. This is given by the fundamental theorem of algebra. Write down theorem 2. Fundamental theorem of algebra. Every rational integral function f of x Every rational integral function f of x has at least one root real or complex. The proof of this theorem is given in higher algebra. Here we give it without proof. Without proof. With the aid of the fundamental theorem of algebra, it is easy to prove the following theorem, theorem 3. Every polynomial of degree n may be factored into n linear factors of the form x minus a and a factor equal to the coefficient of x to the power of n. Write down it. Every polynomial of degree n may be factored into n linear factors of the form x minus a and a factor equal to the coefficient of x to the power of n. Proof. Let f at x be a polynomial of degree n. F of x is a0 times x to the power of n plus a first x n minus 1 plus etc. plus a n. By virtue of the fundamental theorem, this polynomial has a least one root. We denote it by a first. Then by the corollary of the remained theorem, yeah, E. We can write F of X is X minus a little a here, capital A here, little a first, different a first, f first of x where f first of x is a polynomial. Is a polynomial of degree n minus 1. If first of x also has a root, we designate it by a second. F first of x is x minus a second times a f second of x, where f second of x is a polynomial of degree n minus 2. Similarly, f second of x is x minus a third times a f third of x. Continuing this process of factoring out linear factors, we arrive at the relation f n minus first of x, x is x minus a nth times f nth, where f nth is a polynomial of degree 0.
Doctor?
Yes?
Sorry, but you can check my name, please.
I don't check you because I read the lecture. I check you in the end of our class, yes?
Okay. Thank you.
Good. Wait. Degree zero, yes. It means some fixed number. This number is obviously equal to the coefficient of x to the power of n. That is, f n is a zero. On the basis of the equalities obtained, we can write f of x is a zero times x minus a first times x minus a second, etc., to x minus a nth. Formula 2. From the expansion 2, it follows that the number a first, a second, etc. to a n are roots of the polynomial f of x. Since upon the substitution x is a first, x is a second, etc. to x is a n, the right side and hence the left becomes zero. Consider next example, example 3. The polynomial f of x is x cubed minus b times x squared plus 11x, maybe here 6, minus 6 becomes 0 when x is 1, x is 2, x is 3. Therefore, x cubed minus 6x squared plus 11x minus 6 equals x minus 1 times x minus 2 times x minus 3. Now, where x is a that is different from a first, a second, etc. to a n's, can be a root of the polynomial f of x, since no factor on the right side of equation 2 that we write up vanishes where x is a. Whence the following proposition: a polynomial of degree n cannot have more than n distinct roots. Write down that. A polynomial of degree n cannot have more than n distinct roots. But then the following theorem obtains. Theorem 4. If the values of two polynomials of degree n phi first of x and phi second of x coincide for n plus 1 distinct values, a 0, a first, a second, etc. to a nth of the argument x then these polynomials are identical. Proof. Denote the difference of the polynomials by f of x. F of x is phi first of x minus phi second of x. It is given that f of x is a polynomial of degree not higher than n that becomes 0 at the point a first, etc. to a nth. It can therefore be represented in the form f of x equals a 0 times x minus a first times x minus a second, etc. to x minus a nth. But it is given that f of x also vanish at the point a 0. Then f of a 0 equals 0. And not a single one of the linear factors equals 0. For this reason, a 0, capital A, equals 0. And then from 2, we wrote down 2 here, from 2. It follows that the polynomial f of x is identically equal to 0. Consequently, f first of x minus phi second, of x identically equal to 0, or pi first of x identically equal to phi second of x. Theorem 5. Theorem 5. If a polynomial P of X equals A 0 times X to the power of N plus A first times X to the power of N minus 1 plus etc. plus A N minus first X plus a n is identically equal to 0, all its coefficients equals 0. All its coefficients equals 0. Proof. Let us write its factorization using formula 2, P of X is A 0 times x to the power of n plus a first times x to the power of n minus 1 plus etc. plus a n minus first x plus a n equals A 0 times x minus a first times etc. 2x minus a nth formula 1 prime. If this polynomial is identically equal to 0, it is also equal to 0 for some value of x different from a first, a second to a nth. But then none of the bracketed values f x minus then none of the bracket. Sorry. Values a x minus a first, x minus a second, etc. to x minus as is equal to 0, and hence a 0 is 0. Similarly, it is proved when a first is 0, a second is 0, and so forth. Theorem 6. If two polynomials are identically equal, the coefficients of one polynomial are equal to the corresponding coefficients of the other. Write down this. If two polynomials are identically equal, the coefficients of one polynomial are equal to the corresponding coefficients of the other. This follows from the fact that the difference between the polynomials is a polynomial and identically equal to zero. Therefore, from the preceding theorem, all its coefficients are zeros. Example 4.
Doctor.
Yes.
Can you check my name?
Not, I don't check your name because I read the lecture right now.
Okay.
Wait. The end of our class. If the polynomial AX cubed plus BX squared plus CX plus D is identically equal to the polynomial. For example, x squared minus 5x then look ax cubed not x cubed a is 0 b times x squared times 1 b is 1 c times x x times minus 5 C is minus 5 and D not D is 0. Now you have 5 minute rest, then we continue. Our next subtitle, the multiple roots of a polynomial. Write down this. The multiple roots of a polynomial. If in the factorization of a polynomial of degree n interlinear factor, f of x will be equal to a0 times x minus a first times x minus a second etc. to x minus a n. Formula 1. Certain linear factors turn out the same. They may be combined and then factorization of the polynomial will yield f of x equals a0 times x minus a first to the power of k first x minus a second to the power of k second etc. to x minus a m's to the power of k m's. formula 1 prime. And k first plus k second plus etc. 2km equals the numbers of roots n. In this case, the root a first is called a root of multiplicity k first. The root a first is called a root of multiplicity k first, or a k first tuple root a second a root of multiplicity k second, etc. Consider the example. The polynomial f of x is x cubed minus 5x squared plus 8x minus 4 may be factored into the following linear factor. F of x is x minus 2 times x minus 2 times x minus 1. This factorization may be written f of x is x minus 2 squared times x minus 1. The root a 1 is 2 is a double root. A second is 1 is a simple root. If a polynomial has a root of a multiplicity k, then we will consider that the polynomial has k coincident roots. Then from the theorem of factorization of a polynomial into linear factors, we get the following theorem. Every polynomial of degree n has exactly n roots, real or complex. all that has been said of the root of a polynomial. F of x equals a zero times x to the power of n plus a first times x to the power of n minus 1 plus etc. to a. Hence, may obviously be formulated in terms of the roots of the algebraic equation. A zero times x to the power of n plus a first times x to the power of n minus 1 plus etc. plus a n equals zero. Let us further prove the following theorem. If for the polynomial f of x, a first is a root of multiplicity k first greater than 1, then for the derivative f prime of x, this number is a root of multiplicity k first minus 1. Proof. If a first is a root of multiplicity k first is greater than 1, then it follows from formula 1 prime that f of x is x minus a first to the power of k first times phi of x, where phi of x is x minus a second times k to the power of k second, etc., to x minus a m's to the power of k m's, does not become zero at x is a first. That is phi of a first not equal to zero. Differentiating, we get f prime of x equals x minus a first to the power of k first minus 1 times c of x. And maybe I write more, maybe here phi of x plus x minus a first k first phi prime of x on x minus a first k first minus 1 k first phi of x plus x minus a first phi prime of x. And if we denote c of x this bracket, we have the formula that I wrote down: x minus a first to the power of k first minus 1 times c of x. And here c of a first is k first times phi of a first plus a first minus a first times phi prime of a first, or does k first times phi of a first not equal to zero? In other words, x is a first is a root of multiplicity k first minus 1. Of the polynomial f prime of x. From the foregoing proof, it follows that if k first is 1, then a first is not a root of the derivative f prime of x. from the proof theorem, it follows that a first is a root of multiplicity k first minus 2 for the derivative f2 prime of x. Is root of multiplicity chi first minus 3 for the derivative f3 prime of x, etc. Or f of a first is 0, f prime of a first is 0, f2 prime of a first is 0, etc. to k first minus 1's derivative of a first is 0 too. But k's derivative of a first is not equal to 0. Five minutes rest and then we continue. The next theme, factorization of a polynomial in the case of complex roots. Factorization. Of a polynomial in the case of complex roots. The roots a first, a second, etc. to a n may be a the real of complex. We have the following theorem. If a polynomial f of x with real coefficients has a complex root a plus bi, it also has a conjugate root a minus bi. Write down it. If a polynomial f of x with real coefficients has a complex root a plus bi, it also has a conjugate root a minus bi. Proof. Substitute in the polynomial f of x a plus bi in place of x. Raise to a power and collect separately term containing I and those not containing I. We then get f of a plus b I equals m plus n I, where m and n are expressions that do not contain I. Since a plus bi is a root of the polynomial, we have f of a plus bi is m plus ni equals 0. When m is 0, n is 0. Now substitute the expression a minus bi for x in the polynomial. Then we get a number that is conjugate the number m plus ni, or f of a minus bi is m minus ni. But m is 0 and n is 0. We prove it. It means f of a minus bi equals 0 minus 0 I or 0. It means a minus bi is a root of the polynomial. Thus, in the factorization, f of x equals a 0 times x minus a first, x minus a second times etc. x minus a nth. The complex root enter as conjugate pairs. multiplying together the linear factor that correspond to a pair of complex conjugate roots, we get a trinomial of degree 2 with real coefficient. X minus A minus BI times X minus A plus BI. Equals X minus A minus BI times X minus A plus BI or X minus A squared plus b squared, or x squared minus 2ax plus a squared plus b squared, or x squared plus px plus q, where p is minus 2a, q is a squared plus b squared, are the real number. If the number a plus bi is a root of multiplicity k, the conjugate number a minus bi must be a root the same multiplicity k, so that factorization of the polynomial will yield the same number of linear factor x minus a plus bi is that of the form x minus a minus bi. Thus, a polynomial with real coefficients into real factors. Of the first and second degree of corresponding multiplicity. That is, f of x equals a zero times x minus a first to the power of k first times x minus a second to the power of k second times etc. times x minus ars to the power of krs times x squared plus p first x plus q first to the power of l first plus etc. plus a x squared plus p s x plus u s to the power of l s, where k first plus k second plus etc. to k s plus 2l first plus etc. plus 2l s equals n, the degree of our polynomial. Next subtitle, interpolation, Lagrange's interpolation formula. Let it be established in the study of some phenomenon that there is a functional relationship, interpolation, Lagrange's interpolation formula. Let it be established in the study of some phenomenon that there is a functional relationship between them. Quantities y and x, which describes the quantitative aspect of the phenomenon. The function y is phi of x is unknown. But experiment has established the values of these functions, but experiment has established the values of this function, y zero, y first, etc., to yn, for certain values of the argument. X zero, x first, etc. to x n. In the interval from A to B. The problem is to find a function as simple as possible from the computational standpoint. For example, a polynomial which would represent the unknown function y is a phi of x on the interval from a to b, either exactly or approximately. In more abstract fashion, the problem may be formulated as follows. Given on the interval from A to B, the values of an unknown function y is phi of x at n plus 1 distinct point x 0, x first, x second, etc. to x nth. Y0 is phi of x0, y first is phi of x first, etc. Y nth is phi of x nth. It is required to find a polynomial p of x of degree is less than or equal to n, that approximately expresses the function phi of x. For such a polynomial, it is natural to take a polynomial whose values at the point x0, x first, x second, etc. to xn coincide with the corresponding values y0, y first, y second, to y nth of the function phi of x. Y axis. X axis. On the x axis. Interval from A to B, and our points x0, x1, etc. are the points 2xn, and in this point we have the values of our function, for example, this y zero, this y first, etc. here, maybe y s, maybe not very long. In the point A, for example, here, in the point B, here. We have any function that consists this function, but we don't know this function, for example, maybe blue, for example, this function. That consists our point, but we know this function, the function y is phi of x, and we would like to plot the polynomial that consists all of this point, any polynomial. Y is p of x. Then the problem which is called the problem of interpolation, a function, maybe write down this, the problem which is called the problem of interpolation a function. Is formulated thus. For a given function phi of x, find a polynomial p of x of degree is less than or equal to n, which for the given values of x zero, x first, etc. to x n, will take on them values y0 is phi of x0, y first is phi of x first, etc. y nth is phi of x nth. For the desired polynomial, take a polynomial of degree n of the form. P of x is c0 times x minus x first times x minus x second times etc. to x minus x nth plus c first times x minus x0 times x minus x second, not x minus x1, and in the first term, not x minus x0, can you see, times x minus xn, etc. And in the last term, we don't write x minus xn and it x minus xn minus 1's formula 1 and define the coefficients. C0, C first, etc. to Cn, so that the following conditions are fulfilled. P of x0 is y0, P of x first is y first, etc. to P of xn is yn. Formula 2. The first if one put maybe just put not very good. X is x zero. Then taking into account equality two, we get y zero is c zero times x minus x first, x minus x second, etc. to x zero, here zero, minus x nth. Whence c zero equals y zero over x minus x first, x zero, sorry, zero minus x second, to x zero minus x nth. In the same way, we find c first. Oh, sorry. Equals y first over in denominator we have all bracket without bracket with x first. It means x first minus x zero, x first minus x second, not x first minus x first, etc. to x first minus x nth. C second, y second, all multiplier without x second minus x second. Etc. to c nth that equal to a nth over x nth minus x zero, x nth minus x first, etc. to x nth minus x n minus first. Substituting these values of the coefficient into one, we get P of x equals x minus x first, x minus x second, to x minus x nth over x zero minus x first, x zero minus x second, to x zero minus x nth times y zero plus x minus x zero, x minus x second, etc. to x minus x nth over x first minus x zero, x first minus x second, to x first minus x nth times y first, etc. to our last summary, x minus x zero, x minus x first, to x minus x n minus first. In denominator we have some way x nth minus x zero, x nth minus x first, etc. to x nth minus x n minus 1. times yn's formula 3. This formula is called the Lagrange interpolation formula. Lagrange interpolation formula. Let it be noted without proof that if a phi of x has a derivative of the n plus first order on the interval from A to B, the error resulting from replacing the function phi of x by the polynomial pi p of x means the quantity r of x is phi of x minus p of x satisfies the inequality modulus of r of x is less than modulus of x minus x zero, x minus x first to x minus x nth times 1 over n plus 1 factorial times maxima of modulus of phi n plus 1's derivative of phi of x note from theorem 4 that we write down today. It follows that the polynomial P of X which we found is the only one that satisfies the given conditions. Consider the example. From experiment, we get the values of the function y is phi of x, y zero is 3, y four. X zero is 1. Y it's 0. First is, for example, minus 5 for X. First is 2. Y second is 4. 4 X second is minus 4. Stop it. It is required to represent the function y is phi of s approximately by a polynomial of degree 2. We have for n is 2. P of x. Equals without 1 x minus 2 x plus 4. In denominator x 0 1 minus 2 1 plus 4. Times 3 y 0 plus without 2 x minus 1 x plus 4. Then with 2, 2 minus 1, 2 plus 4. Times y first minus 5 plus without minus 4 x minus 1 x 0 x minus 2 with minus 4 minus 4 minus 1 minus 4 minus 2 times 4. Or if we calculate, we will have P of x will be equal to minus 39 over 30 times x squared minus 123 over 30 times x and plus 262 over 30. 5 minute rest and then next subtitle on the best approximation of functions by polynomials, Chebyshev's theory. Write down this. Where am I? On the best approximation of functions by polynomials, Chebyshev's theory. A natural question follows from what has been discussed in the previous section. If a continuous function phi of s is given on the closed interval from a to b, can this function be represented approximately in the form of a polynomial p of x to any predefined degree of degree? In other words, it is possible to choose a polynomial p of x such that the absolute difference between phi of x and p of x at all points of the interval from a to b should be less than any predefined positive number epsilon. The following theorem, which we give without proof, answer this question in the affirmative. Where stress, approximation theorem. A function phi of x is continuous on a closed interval from a to b. If a function phi of x is continuous on a closed interval from A to B, then for every epsilon is greater than zero, there exists a polynomial P of X such that modulus f of x minus p of x is less than epsilon for every x in the interval. The outstanding Bernstein gave the following method of direct construction of such polynomials that are approximately equal to the continuous function phi of x on the given interval. Let phi of x be continuous on the interval from 0 to 1. We write the expression bn of x equals sum over m from 0 to n of phi of m over n c n m x to the power of m 1 minus x to the power of n minus m. Here c n m are binomial coefficients equals n factorial over m factorial over n minus m factorial. Phi of m over n is the value of the given function at the point x is m over n. The expression bn of x is an nth degree polynomial called the Bernstein polynomial. Bernstein polynomial. If an arbitrary epsilon is greater than zero, is given, one can choose a Bernstein polynomial that is select its degree n such that for all values of x on the interval from 0 to 1. The following inequality will be fulfilled. Bn of x minus pi of x modulus of this is less than epsilon. It should be noted that consideration of the interval from 0 to 1 and not an arbitrary interval from A to B is not an essential limitation of generality. Since we changing the variable x is a plus t times b minus a, it is possible to convert any interval from a to b into interval from 0 to 1. In this case, the nth degree polynomial will be transformed into a polynomial of the same degree. The creator of the theory of best approximation of function by polynomials in the Russian mathematic Chebyshev in this field he obtained the most profound result which exerted a greater influence on the work of later mathematician. Maybe in this moment we can stop it our lecturing.